Yeah, this is one of them melon cuts about my life story from beginning all the way up until now. Here we go, here we go, here we go. When I was a young boy growing up in Compton, Emzy was the first place that I graduated from. I was doing anything to find some action. Back in them days, the nigga was hooked on Pac-Man. Had a few girlfriends, not really bucking, cause when you're that young, it's all about humping. Being a youngster was fun galore, not a care in the world cause everything was paid for. Hide and go get it was the game on Chester. I peeped when I counted to avoid it ain't Esther. Damn when you have fun, how time flies. School again, now I'm off for junior high. Went to Willowbrook on Wilmington and Elsie Gondo. Freeman was the principal, damn it was fun though. Everybody kicking it, having a ball. I used to even ditch at the Carson Mall. Had a bus pass for the RTD, so where I needed to go, it was straight up on G. Moving right along, it was still long though. Time for high school, so I went to Centennial. Engineer suit, not trying to boast, but that's the only damn thing I remember the most. Had freaks up the is ass when I went to class. Sometimes I wonder how a nigga even passed, but I did, and Compton was loped, and all the homeboys was getting straight up smoked, either that or getting stretched, and jumping out hall. Los Patrinos wasn't nice at all, it was too much for Frost being locked up, G, so I moved with my relatives in IE. I thought it'd be cooler to live in the track, but I left Vietnam to move to Iraq. North Fontana, it's only right, I spent a little time in Delman Heights, freaks all around. To meet the new nigga that was in they town. I met one girl and we had three kids. Growing up fast, cause that's how it is. Learn how to rap, last not least, from my homie Big Dog, rest in peace. Straight ripping niggas up, at my best. Straight fade they ass at the mall and the crest. Time to get serious and make some sense. So I made a funky tape called The Ghetto Prince. Some disrespected, tried to fake it. Didn't ever think that a nigga would make it. Some tried to copy, sloppy. And then they wanna talk about me and my posse, but we don't really care cause we're rolling with rhythm and hard digging. Bubble gum is exactly what we give them, cause instead of doing good, they're trying to top me. But in IE, I sold 5,000 copies, took it to LA to see if they'd approve, and quickly start selling cause of Frosty's rule. But it wasn't enough, I wanted all the show, so we hopped in my van and went down to San Diego. Selling out quick, tired of making that trip, but damn, money is money, and I got to have it. Then came the show, suckers still had doubt, and that's why I turned they weak ass out. Cause instead of getting with me, they try to go against me. It don't make sense, a bunch of jokers trying to fuck with a prince. Although I'm underground, it makes me feel good and laugh when people ask me for my autograph. Little kids straight know me by my name and face, and those that bought my tape be all on my case. Like, when's the next tape? How come you don't have a video? I tell them I'm underground, but they don't hit me though. And some must think I'm in this shit for fun, saying somebody stole their tape and can I give them another one? Or I heard you made a tape and didn't give me one. Give me a breather, cause other rappers you listen to didn't give you one either. I guess it's just cause they know me and I'm in the limelight, is the reason they sweat me every day and every night. And other rappers try to diss me on the scene, but now that I'm rolling, they wanna jump on the team. But when it comes to underground, damn, I'm the king, falling everywhere I go with a gangster team. Praise to the Almighty for making things.